Hell. Do you like my poinsettia?
I'm kind of forcing the movement there.
Wow.
Yeah, we always watch Phill Lovett.
Don't like you.
Yeah, oh my God. I've just seen what you're wearing.
Morning, commas. Beautiful morning.
Just cut the wrong one off.
What?
This one I meant to cut off.
You've killed your orchid?
I repotted them and it's looking a little bit sad. Just cut the wrong flowers. Right off.
Do you know?
Oh, no, maybe I didn't. Oh, I don't know. I think I'll just cut them both off, shall I? It looks pretty dead. Dying.
Yeah, dead.
Well, dying. So I've just sterilised my scissors.
You know it's bin day today?
Yeah, so you've got to do the bin. I'm watching my YouTube, haven't I?
You love YouTube now, don't you? Who's your favourite YouTuber?
Miss Orchid Girl.
Oh. Sorry, Ed. Sorry, Phil.
Come Hunt TV.
And then...
Oh, I can't decide.
You love watching Ed's dunkery attempt, didn't you?
I did, yeah. Yeah, we always watch Phill Lovett.
Yeah, Bullet Bell.
Bullet Bell, yeah.
You know, I'm off to the gym. Phill Lovett wants me to show him how to do a training session.
Is that what's
yeah,
happening?
That's what I think he said in the message. So I've got to go and show him how to do some lifts and weights.
Right.
I haven't done that since about 18, so...
18
two years ago. I've got a little treat for Jayne, haven't I?
Yeah.
We probably won't show you that, because the reaction will be funnier. Oh, well, they'll need to know what he's reacting to.
Right, so we're off to the gym. Let's see if they're here yet. Probably are. I'm late. I've been doing a thumbnail. Might go and see Stuart Lowen afterwards as well.
You're out of focus. Hold on. It's Tim!
What's
Hi Tim!
Up?
How are you? You're still out of focus. What's going on here? I don't like you. There we go, it's Tim. Where are we, Tim?
We're at fitness station Minehead and Big Scott's in the house.
Got a website?
Yeah. Fitness station gym Facebook. Yeah.
I'll put a link below.
Yeah.
Link in the description. Best five-a-side player in Minehead?
Oh.
Maybe not now. I mean, look at the size of you. Bloody animal.
A bit of weight on, I think.
Yeah, those were the days, weren't they?
A bit more there as well, unfortunately.
Well, I won't go down too low. We got a sensation coming today.
Who's that?
Phill Lovett.
Phill Lovett?
Yeah.
Isn't he like the best cyclist in UK or something?
No, he came yesterday.
Oh, right.
You've missed him. He's Ed Laverack. Go on, Ed! Christ, I don't even go down that fast.
A new Land Rover. Always be rolling. I can't deny you though. I can't deny you.
Yeah, oh my God. I've just seen what you're wearing.
I just seen what you were. Oh my God. Where's
Tim's just been saying, so someone in prison or something? I was like, yeah. Well, literally, she is. The size of these, Phil? Crikey.
They're adequate, Scott.
What do we do? 50 reps on those?
60s. I mean, 60s is insane. I'm now about to pick up a me or an Ed Laverack.
It's not by no means.
Remember what Arnold says?
What Arnold says? Through pain. I can't remember what I was saying.
Wow. Wow. Oh my word. How many reps are you going to do? What a way to start a workout, Phil.
They got 62.5 as well.
Have they got a 98.7?
No.
Are you going to try and lift me?
I believe we can put 98.7 in.
Right. Right, so what's the plan today, Phil?
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what we've got.
Oh, it's like a torture machine.
Yeah? No, we're going to focus on the deadlift.
Deadlift today.
So we just had a tiny little warm-up with just the bar. Scott needs a little bit more flexibility, and we can help that with the warm-up. Feet just outside shoulder width apart. You're going to kind of rest onto your heels, and then gradually you're going to just try and open up the hips by pushing those knees out further over the toes and trying to get the chest up, because gradually all the muscles in this area and the hip hinge area are just going to free up a little bit. It'll take maybe a bit longer for you. You'll just get into a really nice deep position such that you can sit on your heels like this. The hamstrings nearly touching the, what's it called? The calf. Well, it's got nice calves.
Yeah.
Quite low now. And look at the back. Right, so it's chest up, retract those shoulder blades. Now gradually sink down and get those elbows in between the knees. That's it. Put your hands on your toes. Try and get your heels on the ground. Oh, sorry. Try and get the heels on the ground. At the moment, the heels are up. You're not going to get any lower than that straight off, yeah? Sorry. Quite hard filming and concentrating. Just stay still. Just stay like that. This is currently a lack of flexibility, yeah? These muscles haven't been in this range of motion for ages. This is very elegant, this position, Scott. The free Jayne. Now I'm getting my revenge. It's like a little bullfrog. How do I hit stop? Oh, that one there.
We really need Scott to focus on opening up the hips more, right? And so here's a nice move. If you put your feet against some kind of solid object like that, just on your knees, trying to get the back up straight. Hinge at the hip, keeping the back straight. Tension through here, keep the bum up. And trying to really... Flexibility is something that has to be worked at just regularly. I stretch typically 4 or 4 times a week in the evening.
It's not the most edifying position, but it's a very good move. I'm going to try and push my butt upwards. Again, the muscles just relax themselves. I don't want to force the movement. I'm kind of forcing the movement there because obviously we're filmed.
Get the hands in a bit closer to your chest. Right, now push the pressure up with the hands and try and force the butt up and keep that lovely straight back, yeah? Push, go on, hinge more. Now wait, if you wait about 15 seconds, the muscles around the hip hinge area, if I've got the names wrong, please do comment. I am not a personal trainer. Force that butt up. Good. All right, now do. Now try and go into that squat position again. Just instantly go into it. Nice. That's instantly looking better. That is literally, hang on a second, that's instantly looking nice. I mean, there's a bow at the upper back, but that's not a problem, right? Depth here, you can see the thigh is touching the calf. So we hit stop. It's chest up, shoulders back. Look how nice and close his shins are to the bar. Perfect. Now go down and grab the bar tight. Now squeeze the glutes and the hamstrings, keep the knees out over the toes and push the ground away from you with your feet. Just feel like, that's it. Keep chest up as you come down, that's nice. And push the ground away with your feet. 15 on each side, so 50 kilograms total. Range of motion is reduced, which means we can really focus on a nice upright back and honing that hinge at the hip movement and pushing through with the hips to really get the glutes and the hamstrings involved. Chest up, air into the core, grab the bar tight, squeeze the lats. The back is nice and straight, pushing the knees almost towards the hands and through with the hips. The bar is staying close, rubbing up against the body, and by smashing through with the hips as quickly as you can, getting the hamstring and the glute involved, and that is what makes a deadlift such an amazing movement.
You're going to get me to 2000 watts doing this, aren't you?
Yes.
Coach Ed said you can.
It will definitely make a difference to the power. Okay, grab that bar tight. This is an unusual move.
Stupid shorts to wear.
Chest up, drive it up, that's it. Get those glutes in as quickly as you can. Push through with the hips harder.
You've seen on a couple of reps there, Scott was bending his arms like this. In the deadlift, the arms stay locked throughout, and all of the lifting is done with the back and the posterior chain and a little bit of quad. We're aiming for the power, which I can't do in the flat.
Good, and down. They were much, much nicer.
We've added a little bit of weight to the bar. We're now on 20 kilograms each side. Just up, shoulders back, tense the lats, air into the mouth, nose, feel the core, brace the abs. Grab tightly, thumbs touching lower leg.
Push those hips. Nice. Nice. Get the chest up. You can see Scott's upper back rounds a tiny bit, but it stays firm throughout the movement. That's just his natural posture. Nice. Can you make an easy work of this? Yeah, don't bounce it. That's it, stop there.
So this is 80 on the bar. That's a lot for me. So I'm really, really focusing very heavily on the form here. The moment the bar speed slows, that's the end. I wouldn't try this for a full range of motion at the current state. Let me try again, actually.
Do you want a pink monster?
So we've got 80 on the bar here.
There we go.
This is not to be trifled with. Chest up, shoulders back. Bring those lats back and tense them, right? Get that chest up. Push the ground away with your feet. Keep those knees out over the toes. Oh my God, that's nice. Put it down, yeah, just put it down and reset. You got a lot of strength. Yeah, you got a lot of strength. Did. Right, just start again. You know the weight, right? You're trying to push through with the hips. We can probably put another 10 on each side for you. Get that back straight. Now push the ground away with your feet. Go on. Through with the hips. Chest up. Through with the hips. This is nice. That's good. Chest up, get that chest up. That's nice. One more. Chest up. Air into the core. And stop.
So we're here at Fitness Station. Wonderful facility here in Minehead. Now it turns out my strength has evaporated.
Right, Phil, session deadlift one. What are we calling this?
We're calling it
the race to 2000 watts.
Yes.
So,
the quest.
When do you think I can do it? Christmas?
No. That's a ridiculously long time frame. I think based on the way your fitness is coming back and the amount of extra kilometers you're doing, plus with a little bit of deadlifting, I'm saying end of September.
Oh, okay. End of September, kids. Don't tell Phil I'm having a sneaky pink monster. No. Right, Phil, can we go home now?
No.
I thought you might say that.
No, it's time for the vanity muscle. The chest and the tries.
Oh, we like the tries for sprinting.
Often neglected in favour of the buys, but I'm more of a try man.
Tries make it look good in the shirt.
Do they? Sure do, yeah. They look particularly good on the vlog from the side.
Yeah.
For me.
Bad lighting today, but...
It's been over 20 minutes.
Right, I'm going with the 20 to mass hit. The 20s are always the most popular.
Right. All right, Eddie Hall.
I like the incline dumbbell press because it works the pectoral muscle completely. You get a bit of shoulder action too. Same kind of setup, right? Chest up, shoulders back, rest the dumbbell on the knee. We settle down, we get the core nice and tight, and we're going to be squeezing the glutes as always. And then get into position and we squeeze the pectoral muscle to begin the movement. Ooh, it's been a while. And then bring it down safely and under control, pause, onto the knees, and done. Now the 20s, again, it's gotta be a good 5 months since I've been in the gym. They were proper difficult with the 20s, as you can see.
X more 20s.
Yeah, I think it must be 30s.
Okay, preparation. All right, okay, yeah, get your sleeves rolled up.
2 tickets, Phil.
Free Jane, I think she's next door.
I forgive you that. Okay, pick them up nicely. Deep breath in through the mouth and nose.
Shoulders back, retract those shoulder blades. Air into the mouth and nose, and get those dumbbells rested on the knees. Into position by kicking the knee up. Oh, okay, yeah, they're right. Arms out a little bit wider. More, a bit more, a bit up more. That's good. This is nice. Okay, stop. You've easily got a lot more weight in you than that. The 20s are on the ground. I think you should be good to go with the 20s. We just have a little break. Yeah. That was ambitious.
Fun now.
And that is how to get injured in the gym. Although, for me, it was the 20s, right?
Nervous system should be warmed up for the upper body.
See how I have a pause at the bottom? Focus is on the mind-muscle connection, making sure I initiate the movement with the chest. My elbows are out a little bit wider than yours at the bottom, look.
Going with the 20s now. We're going with the 17 and a halfs. Right. One, two, a bit deeper, tiny bit deeper. That's good. Four, this is nice. Five, three more. Squeeze the pecs. Seven, and stop.
The things I do for his thumbnail, right?
Yeah, thanks, Phil. I appreciate that.
Getting the weight back in.
That was a team effort.
It was a trial.
I was nearly going to ask Jane to do it for us.
It was like Scott pushing Billy uphill.
Now, Scott's got us into a little bit of bother here.
This is what I hate.
Right.
I hate the
tail. Go, go, bullet, bail.
Go.
I've got to say, that's pretty smooth. That was nice.
Hell, do you like my poinsettia?
So that's me basically lifting up an Ed Laverack.
Well, right, thanks for that.
And now for a comp hunt.
Thankfully, maybe next week. Where are we going?
To the hills.
Thanks, Jane. Free Jane.
That's the bar. These are the business.
Look at that.
Very much.
I'm not going to share our things.
That's about a 15 kilo.
20 grams of protein, loads of fiber, vegan source of protein, peas, brown rice, rinse. There you go.
Impressive.
Thumb now.
Right.
What is this?
Oh, Stuart Lowen from the videos.
How's the comment going?
Love the peanut butter. Really smooth and boring.
Wonderful. How are you doing, Nikki? Did you watch the ramp test?
No.
Why?
Well, some of us have horses to deal with.
Stuart's going to do a ramp test.
Are you doing a ramp test? Nice. It's going to be emotional then.
Fun?
Yeah, definitely.
So we are and get back into it.
Yeah, I kind of like that last 3 minutes.
I like the first 2 minutes.
You're like, yeah, what
do
you like?
When you're gassing away.
Yeah. I would have done better if I stopped talking.
I think you probably might have done. You never know.
Dream as well.
Yeah, the live stream raises the heart rate by about 10 beats a minute.
And the aero bar.
The aero bomb.
Mint aero.
Do you eat a mint aero bomb?
Yeah.
Thank you. You went down so fast.
Is that recovery cake?
It's quality carbs, that is. We're going to see Jane's Uncle Pete. I think it's good form. If you're having tea, take cake.
And if you're not having tea, take cake.
Well, yeah, that's a good mantra to live life by.
It is round here. Not on the cider again tonight, are you?
No. Maybe a red wine. Scott says it's Triggs Broom or bikes because basically I bought it on eBay. Had to replace the wheels, the groups, the stems, the handlebars.
Right, so we're out of the gym, out of Phil Lovett's natural habitat there, so that was brilliant. I feel really loose now. Phil's going to get both barrels, going to get a full sprint, I think. And how are you feeling, Phil?
No pressure.
No pressure, no. So no, we're going to go for a little comm hunt.
So here we are.
Twirl or whisper?
I am tempted.
You can't leave here without fudging crowns. He'll be so stropping, he doesn't know where I've put his jersey. What have you lost there, Phil?
I lost his jersey.
Take Phil up the nut and bottom.
Only in Minehead.
1 week in Exmoor and he's ruined. Clotted cream.
Yeah, so where did he put it then?
I don't know, I can't remember now.
Coach Laverack, we'll be back on point shortly.
Nat just melted listening to him.
Heart rate was like...
Because your legs are done, aren't they? They're still shaking.
We'll go gravel riding. Remember, no watts per kilo.
I love carpool. Pile in, spoonful after spoonful.
This has got your name all over it. Love it, Phil.
That's a winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Thank you, your dream bike.
18 kilometres an hour. No, 18 miles an hour. Actually,
don't do that.
Super safe. Hot lats, I think. Yeah, definitely some hot lats.
Chris Hoy, eat your heart out. Chris Hoy, eat your heart out. So Chris Hoy, eat your heart out. So Chris Hoy, eat your heart out.